behave differently from the way we behaved before? They ruined their souls, and what they used to invent has failed them. Your Lord is Allah, He who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days, then established Himself on the throne. The night overtakes the day, as it pursues it persistently, and the sun, and the moon, and the stars are subservient by His command. His is the creation, and His is the command. Blessed is Allah, Lord of all beings. Call upon your Lord humbly and privately. He does not love the aggressors. And do not corrupt on earth after its reformation, and pray to Him with fear and hope. Allah's mercy is close to the doers of good. It is He who sends the wind ahead of His mercy. Then, when they have gathered up heavy clouds, we drive them to a dead land, where we make water come down, and with it we bring out all kinds of fruits. Thus we bring out the dead. Perhaps you will reflect. As for the good land, it yields its produce by the leave of its Lord. But as for the bad, it produces nothing but hardship and misery. Thus we explain the revelations in various ways for people who are thankful. We sent Noah to his people. He said, O my people, worship Allah, you have no God other than Him. I fear for you the punishment of a tremendous day. The dignitaries among his people said, We see that you are in obvious error. He said, O my people, I am not in error, but I am a messenger from the Lord of the worlds. I deliver to you the messages of my Lord, and I advise you, and I know from Allah what you do not know. Do you wonder that a reminder has come to you from your Lord, through a man from among you, to warn you, and to lead you to righteousness, so that you may attain mercy? But they called him a liar. So we saved him and those with him in the ark, and we drowned those who rejected our revelations. They were blind people. And to add, their brotherhood. He said, O my people, worship Allah, you have no God other than Him. Will you not take heed? The elite of his people who disbelieved said, We see foolishness in you, and we think that you are a liar. He said, O my people, there is no foolishness in me, but I am a messenger from the Lord of the worlds. I convey to you the messages of my Lord, and I am a trustworthy advisor to you. Are you surprised that a reminder has come to you from your Lord, through a man from among you, to warn you? Remember how he made you successors after the people of Noah, and increased you greatly in stature. And remember Allah's blessings, so that you may prosper. They said, Did you come to us to make us worship Allah alone, and abandon what our ancestors used to worship? Then bring us what you threaten us with, if you are truthful. He said, Condemnation and wrath have befallen you from your Lord. Are you arguing with me over names, which you and your ancestors invented, for which Allah sent down no authority? Just wait, I am waiting with you. So we saved him and those with him, by mercy from us, and we cut off the roots of those who rejected our revelations and were not believers. And to Thamud, their brother Salih, he said, O my people, worship Allah, you have no God other than Him. Clarification has come to you from your Lord. This she-camel of Allah is a sign for you. So leave her to graze on Allah's earth, and do her no harm, lest a painful penalty seizes you. And remember how he made you successors after Ad, and settled you in the land. You make for yourselves mansions on its plains, and carve out dwellings in the mountains. So remember Allah's benefits, and do not roam the earth corruptingly. The elite of his people, who were arrogant, said to the common people who had believed, Do you know that Salih is sent from his Lord? They said, We are believers in what he was sent with. Those who were arrogant said, We reject what you believe in. So they hamstrung the she-camel, and defied the command of their Lord, and said, O Salih, bring upon us what you threaten us with, if you are one of the messengers. Whereupon the quake overtook them, and they became lifeless bodies in their homes. Then he turned away from them, and said, O my people, I have delivered to you the message of my Lord, and I have advised you, but you do not like those who give advice. And Lot, when he said to his people, Do you commit lewdness? No people anywhere have ever committed before you. You lust after men rather than women. You are an excessive people. And his people's only answer was to say, Expel them from your town, they are purest people. But we saved him and his family, except for his wife, she was of those who lagged behind. And we rained down on them rain, note the consequences for the sinners. And to Madian, their brother Chuib, he said, O my people, worship Allah, you have no God other than him. A clear proof has come to you from your Lord. Give full measure and weight, and do not cheat people out of their rights, and do not corrupt the land once it has been set right. This is better for you, if you are believers. And do not lurk on every path, making threats and turning away from the path of Allah those who believe in him, seeking to distort it. And remember how you were few, and how he made you numerous. So note the consequences for the corruptors. Since some of you believed in what I was sent with, and some did not believe, be patient until Allah judges between us, for he is the best of judges. The arrogant elite among his people said, O Chuib, we will evict you from our town, along with those who believe with you, unless you return to our religion. He said, Even if we are unwilling, we would be fabricating falsehood against Allah, if we were to return to your religion, after Allah has saved us from it. It is not for us to return to it, unless Allah, our Lord, wills. Our Lord embraces all things in knowledge. In Allah we place our trust. Our Lord, decide between us and our people in truth, for you are the best of deciders. The elite of his people who disbelieved said, If you follow Chuib, you will be losers. Thereupon, the quake struck them, and they became lifeless bodies in their homes. Those who rejected Chuib, as if they never prospered therein. Those who rejected Chuib, it was they who were the losers. So he turned away from them, and said, O my people, I have delivered to you the messages of my Lord, and I have advised you. So why should I grieve over a disbelieving people? We did not send any prophet to any town, but we afflicted its people with misery and adversity, so that they may humble themselves. Then we substituted prosperity in place of hardship, until they increased in number, and said, Adversity and prosperity has touched our ancestors. Then we seized them suddenly, while they were unaware. Had the people of the towns believed and turned righteous, we would have opened for them the blessings of the heaven and the earth, but they rejected the truth, so we seized them by what they were doing. Do the people of the towns feel secure that our might will not come upon them by night, while they sleep? Do the people of the towns feel secure that our might will not come upon them by day, while they play? Do they feel safe from Allah's plan? None feel safe from Allah's plan except the losing people. Is it not guidance for those who inherit the land after its inhabitants, that if we willed, we could strike them for their sins? And seal up their hearts, so that they would not hear? These towns, we narrate to you some of their tales. Their messengers came to them with the clear signs, but they would not believe in what they had rejected previously. Thus Allah seals the hearts of the disbelievers.